Foxhooker e Sharper Trades, market mixed with the bullish technicals and the ATMA holding the support quite nicely. The day was mixed, closing in the red, but that's okay. It still shows bullish sentiment. Need to see a push through this high, 470, 65, all-time high, 479. This channel top around, let's see, 485 and then 492. All right, looking to the individual stocks we traded today, and mentioned AI is a swing, a little bit of a pain in the neck, but price is not cooperating yet. The technicals are improving. I like what I see. In the pre-market was up right at the basically our entry point around 51, 51.62, and then it came down. So there was some bearish pressure. The important thing is that it's back above all the moving averages, and this base is currently holding. So what we don't want to see tomorrow is a lower opening and a move slash close below today low, and then most importantly, those lows down there. So maybe a sideways consolidation with a hammer, it's okay. What I want to see is a break above 52 holding, and if we get them move, technicals again are improving. Then we're looking for 56, 61, 67, and 73. This has a lot of potential as it came from 182. Not gonna get there right away, but I think at some point it will. But for now, those are the first targets we are looking at. Supports are the same, 47, 45. ATVI, we're catching the low. So far it's working well. This is in no list, but was discussed last week and Friday and today. Today close above 70. My first target, if you swing it long, 73 and then 79 and 85. And so far it's working well. I do have a position, so happy with the current progression. The support is today low 68 and 66, those lows down there. PA. Yeah, it was mentioned a few times already. It looks like it's trying to make a move. It's still in this consolidation, so vulnerable to a pullback. But important piece is that it broke above the 20 simple moving average with volume. This is important. Now, this company trades ton of volume option, I mean shares, but this is the largest volume increase we've seen in about on an up day in about 5 months, 4 months since, let's see, since here, 4 months. So let's see if he does roll over like he did that or extends. I will expect a retest of today low. That's 226. If you swing it, that's your primary support. And then the secondary support is down at the 50 simple moving average. I'm looking for a breakout of the trend line, 251 first target. And then 287 and 327. BE, this is a swing, looks like it's done. It's reached several targets, 35 was a resistance. On Friday, looked like he had some more energy to go. He didn't. He opened lower. So after an indecision, doji, the following candle tells us the direction. If he opens lower, generally, they take it down. If he opens higher, generally, they take it up. In this case, he opened lower, bounced up a little bit. You see the presence of an upper shadow. And that was the it. That was the resistance and immediately went down. So this shows with the volume increase now a selling sentiment, selling pressure increasing. So for us, this is at the borderline, secondary support 30. These folks came from a peer, 26. So don't give it back, right? Make your profit, and 30 is the secondary support. If he comes back above 33 and then takes out 36, then we're looking at 38, 41, 44, and 48. BLNK, impressive big day today. This is, was mentioned last week, and today was a day trade that acted quite well, a little bit restless with several ups and downs, but important pieces that form this rectangle, triangle, then it broke out with this volume right there. So this was the key moment. were rallied during the lunch hours, did a pullback, tested the 200 simple day moving average, and what was 42? 42 held and then went up. So this was the catalyst, all this volume around the lunch hours that propelled to 44 and 47, reached two targets. As the day trade obviously was done, that was towards the end of the session. In the after hour market is down a little bit. This is in the Susan short squeeze scan. It's a regular participant of that scan, so heavily shorted. So it's expected to make those kind of moves. It's also very volatile, so be careful. If you swing it after today candle 44, 43.50, just for safety, and then today low 40. Looking for 51, 54, 58, and 62 if you extend. Coin seems setting up nicely. And it's been already 4 days since the awful earnings report, awful digestion of it. So the information has been digested okay, and technicals remain bullish, nice and green. Unless he opens lower tomorrow, it comes back above the ATMA and then start heading down, then we have a wave one, wave two, and then wave three is going to take it lower. The support is Friday low, 332, and Wednesday low, 320. 365, 392, 396, and 429. Correct, so they trade, reached the target, then the steep pullback was done, obviously. But keep an eye on it, volume is good. And you know, with those kind of stocks, you never know. They can make a big day and then the following day open lower and down. So just be cautious, but keep an eye on it, because if it does some sort of consolidation with lower shadows and comes back above 270 to 80, then it's a potential to go higher. And if it does 350, 430, 530, 640, and 770. Support is today low. 238, and then below that, you have to look down at the 3MA. Dollar tree, a day trade, and a swing idea that last week I said I'm done following it. Those are your targets. Today is back in the list because of the day trade and the disclosure of a stake by one of the asset management. It's still has a potential. I'm done following it, but this looks like wants to go some more. Looking for 135, 143, 152, and 162. Support is today low, 121, and then the ATMA. Etsy looks good. It needs to break the 283.40 all-time high, target 318, 355, and 400. Support ATMA in this red candle low at 233, 243. Ford seems ready to at least setting up for the next wave up. If the ATMA holds, that would be the support I'm looking at. So for now, trade the ATMA. And the support that must hold for me if it does any pullback is 1880. And then below that is this red candle low at 1770. I think there's more to go. My only concern is that this is near the channel top. So any lower opening, expect what did in the past, like you know, something like that. Gaps up and then goes lower. So keep the stops in place and tighten, because this has been up a decent amount so far, you know, since here. So what was it? $15 to $25. It's quite good. FSR Fisker. Unfortunately, I have not re-entered a position, so I'm just watching this thing go up. But if you are still in this position, I hope you are. Congratulations, it's working quite nicely. After having broke the 200 simple the moving average, is extending. Came as high as 22.23 a few days ago, and setting up to what might be the next wave up. 23, 25. 27 channel top, and then eventually possibly 29. Support ATMA and this red candle low 1820. HST, I spotted dark pool activity today, large 2,1765. Again, with dark pool activity, we don't know the direction, we just know that institutions are positioning themselves, can be bearish or bullish. We don't know the direction. We just know the large position has been placed. Now, because of the volume and the look of this chart, speculation is bullish. It's in the hotel sector, and with the world kind of reopening a little bit, travel is starting again. We're going into the holiday season where people travel. We can project a bullish move. So, but we, you know, we gotta keep the stops in place. So I'm placing a longer trade with the stop. But primary support is this low. I mean, super tight 1750. And what I'm looking at is the 50 SMA. But you can also use this level 1785 as the place to pay attention to. If it's above it, it's bearish, is bullish, sorry. If price moves above it, it's bullish. If price moves below it, it's bearish. So look for, like if you move past this high, 1837, 1840, then bullish energy. If it breaks below this this low, 1765, and then takes out the 17, then shows bearish energy. Okay. So keep an eye on those levels. This is in our list, and I just like to throw those things there because you know they can have potential for good moves. And 19, 20, 30, 21, 68, and 23, possibly channel top around 24. Those are my targets. HYZN in consolidation above the 50 simple the moving average. I like the look of it. Looking for 840. 960 and 1130 support 50 SMA and Friday low at 680. Lazar was mentioned last week. Today popped, testing the 200 simple moving average. Technicals are bullish. Look at the volume a few days ago. This is many millions. What was it? 72. Now it needs to break the 200. If it does, then look for a test of this high, 24, 23, 90. Targets 25, 28, 31. The support, 20, let's see, this high, 20, 50, and the same day, low, 18, 70. Macy's. Macy's reports earnings in 3 days. So be aware of this. It's a swing that has worked quite nicely. From down here, we enter on, I think, this day or this day, I can't remember it exactly. It reached already several targets, 27, 29, 32. Now it's setting up possibly the next wave up. We'll see if it does it. This is the mid channel and currently holding. Look for a move past 32, 34, 37, 41, or more just in case this thing blows out the water with earnings, 45. And the support is 29 and 27. Let me double check quickly. Make it 29 and 27. Meso, a day trade, acted well. Came as high as 728 before pulling back. It didn't do much of a move, but I like the volume. But you know, this is something that doesn't move much. So I wouldn't hold it overnight. If you do, your stop is 660. Support, if he extends 870, I mean, targets 870, 1020, 12, and 13. MRAM, swing idea, was a day trade on Friday. Today made a good move, reached the target already, 12.47, and a pullback. I'm looking for 14, 16, 19, and 21. Support right now is 11, the Friday high, and today low, 970. The third level would be the ATMA, but that's too far down. MTTR, Susan brought this to our attention, a good day trade. Acted well right at the open, then consolidated, and then got a push into the close to 27 and closing rather well. Now, this might be done as a day trade if you plan to swing it, the support 25.80 and then half of the candle around 24.80. 28, 30, 32, and 34 next targets. Pins. Pins is a swing. It's currently working. The pop came as high as 48.86. The first target for us is 49.71 and then the 50 SMA. Technicals are improving. What we don't want to see is a bearish kicker and move a open below today opening price, and then these things are heading lower. That will be problematic. But so far, the base is holding nicely. Now I'm looking for the 50 SMA, 53, 56, 61, and 64. Those are the targets. Support, tighten a little bit now. Make it 46 and 43. The secondary is the same. QS has been in our watch list for a while, and some of you is trading it. Susan added to the swing idea, I think, on Thursday. They popped, came to 43.08, pull back, technicals are bullish, looking for 43.60, 47.60, 54, 53, and 57. Support ATMA and this red candle low at 33.60. Roblox, love the look of it. This is working very well for us. Look for a move past this high, 110. Targets 114, 126, 138. Support is 102, 103, and the ATMA. Both relatively tight, but you know, I gotta protect this profit. Real is a swing idea that I like so far. I took some profit today and looking for a re-entry simply because I had a shortest expiration, was like a few days. Looking for a better re-entry. And then look for a move past 17.09, targets 18, 19.60, 22, and 24. Support 16.15. Riot explosive in the pre-market, reached already the second target of the new targets. So it came to 45 and 48. And then did the kind of a double top. And then as soon as you open, it went down. Got a bounce and then rolled over. Disappointing, obviously, if you didn't take profits. But if you're looking for re-entry, I think this eventually is going to go much higher. I'm not sure if it's reporting earnings or not. I think earnings are done. But in fact, let me look it up. Because sometimes this day doesn't say correctly. Hang with me. Let me look for the earnings. Earnings. Reports. No, maybe he hasn't reported yet. Well, in which case today, after our market, pre-market, I don't know. I'm not seeing here any earnings report notification. So do your research if you still have this position. Unfortunately, I can't find any. I'll do more research, and if I find something, I will post it. And now tighten the stops. Right? This is already the pullback. Primary support was 43 out. Secondary support is down at the ATMA. Let me see. We updated today. And go there. Riot 37. 41. No. Okay. Not yet. 43 and 39. 43 and 39. Okay. So 43 and 39. 39 will be slightly around the ATMA. I'm looking for, again, a test of 48, 52, 56, and 61. RIVN, incredible. This keeps on giving. Today came as high as 152. Personally, I took profit a little too early. This is extending. For me, let's see if it does any pullback. But, you know, with the electric vehicle and companies like Amazon and Ford behind it, trade this channel. If you're still in this position, congratulations. If you're looking for a re-entry, I look for a pullback, but it might not come. The pullback might come when it's done. So be aware of that. And support now is the VWP and then those down around 130. Root right now is not working. This is a swing that blow out the wall and then did a pullback. It's always disappointing when those things happen. I'm not surprised it did make this move. When we initiated the trade was this day, was around 550, did a pullback, went up to 6, did a pullback, and then on the move up, we entered. And then that day came as high as 649, was acting well, then did the pullback. The following day, gapped up, and it went down. I didn't like to see that, but I say, you know, please keep an eye on this one on the 50 simple moving average as the support the must hold. That would be the primary support. If he opens lower, start heading down, most likely will come and test the base, 450. So there's a possibility we'll go down there and retest again. To start working again, needs to come back above the 50. Right now, this is borderline, holding the support at 5. Needs to come back above the 50 simple moving average and then break past 6 again, 610. And if we see them move, then the targets are 7, 8, 920, 1040, 1069, up to the 200 simple moving average. Right now, not working. Snap made the base and pop today. It was a day trade, acted well, up to 57, pullback retest. It was quiet as a day trade, but it's quite a bit of a volume. Some increase, but the column wall was increasing significantly. I'm looking for 61 above the 66, 73, and 81. Support 53 if you swing it, and then this low 51.40. Sophie made a move today. Now is upgraded to 30. It's currently 23, and that spiked a bullish energy price. So went up to 24.12 to be precise, but then fell, went down right after the open. Have to look at this 1 minute chart. Popped, double top, made a V bottom. This was good at that point, but then double top at the level and then rolled over. So a little bit disappointing as I closed. What I do like, however, is the volume is green and it's holding the primary support, which is the ATMA around 2280. And the secondary support is this low 2150. I'm looking for 2437. This is the target already reached. And next, I'm looking after that, 26, 28, and 30, 55. TTD is in a list, was mentioned last week, they trade, and as you swing it, broke 90.97, looks like wants to go, volume is good, today came as high as 108.52, target was 110. Above that, if he makes a move and extends, 125, 143, 161. Support is 97, 97 and 93 at the ATMA. VFF, swing idea, marijuana, volume is good. Pop the 50 SMA and 850, did a pullback with some indecision. Now with indecision again, whatever he opens, tells the direction. Currently is opening higher and is moving higher, but any lower opening and the close below it, and then if you start taking out the ATMA, which is the primary support, and then heads lower, then it's done. Support ATMA and 50 SMA, I'm looking for 10, 1160, 1340, and 1549. Visio on the move. This was a swing that did not work there, did a rollover, came all the way down to 17, got a bounce, and now looks like it's ready to make a move. Today popped the trend line extending out of the swing idea. If he holds if he held that the breakout point currently is holding, so let's see if he extends 23, 26, 28, and 32. Support ATMA and 50 SMA. Let's see, actually, this low. 2070 and 50 SMA, 1930. Woof, mostly done. Reports earnings in a few days on the 18th. The pullback, volume increased today. It's opening lower, gapped up, open lower, moved up, closed below Friday close. Presence of a Pashado, it's below the ATMA. So this is now showing some bearish trend. Take your profit, raise your stops, and already moved past the primary support. And this has been a swing of us since August. It's already several targets. And right now, let's see, we're looking at 25 and 23 primary and secondary support. And finally, Yala. Yala day trade did okay today, came up to 10.4 and then a pullback. On the daily chart, looks bullish. Broke the 50 SMA, did the pullback. Today popped another pullback. Look for a move past 966 and stick above it. If it does, our targets moving forward, 11.22, 13.40, 16. And one more, the 200 simple moving average, currently 1760. Support today low,